Hi guys, this is Lauren from Tata Robotics. Today I'm going to be taking you through a basic tutorial on how to use our flight stand software. This software works with all of our flight stand test stands and has some great new features that our clients have been asking for. In this video, I'm just going to cover the basics, but you can check out our other videos on our channel for more in-depth tutorials. The software is in active development and some features are liable to change, but for this tutorial I'm using version 1.6.3. So starting out, this is the homepage of the software, and if you look at the drop-down menu, the order of events is in a logical order based on what you're going to need to do. So first, you're going to need to set up, choose your hardware, set safety limits, and name your powertrains. Then you can run either a manual or automatically controlled test, and then finally, under the test tab, you can see your recorded test data and export it. So we'll start on the setup tab. And this is where you can set your units of measurement. And you just choose whatever ones are best for you, most useful for your team. And then we'll move on to the hardware tab. So a really great feature about the new software is that you can connect a simulated board. So at this stage, you would either plug in your flight stand test stand via USB or click the connect simulated board. And now we can see that our simulated hardware is connected. And we can see some sort of baseline data coming in for Powertrain 1. We can actually connect two boards at once to simulate a coaxial or dual motor powertrain system, but for now we're just going to do one, and I'll cover two powertrains in another video. So then we will go to the firmware tab and make sure that we have the most up-to-date version of the software. And if we go to built-in systems, this will show us where we have data measurement coming in from. So right now we have nothing plugged into our servo ports nor our temperature probe, but we do have data coming in at baseline for current, thrust, RPM, torque, and voltage. So then we'll head on over to the next tab, which is the safety limits. And the system already has some limits built in, but if we want to restrict them even further to protect our motor, ESC, battery, etc., we can set min and max cutoffs. I'm just going to leave them as the system limits for this test. And then we can map our powertrains. So here we can name our motor, propeller, ESC, and our power source. For the purpose of this test, since I'm using simulated boards, I'm just going to leave it as motor 1, propeller 1, ESC 1, and say I'm using a 30 kilowatt power source. But if you wanted to specify the brand or the size or the metrics associated with your motor, propeller, or ESC, this would be the place to do it, and that can be really useful for comparing tests in the future to see what powertrain setup worked the best for you. So first off, we will try running a manually controlled test. So I'll just name this one manual control. There we go. And there's two ways to record data. First, we can click here to record continuous data, or we can use this button to take samples. And to activate our ESC, we simply click the button here. And then we can control our throttle input by either inputting values here or using the throttle slider. So I'll start us off at, say, 1300 and enter that there. And then I'll start continuously recording data. So we have our powertrain at 1300. Then I can use the slider to drag it up even higher, or back lower. And whenever we're done playing with it, we can stop recording and then save our test. And so the software will save this test and we'll be ready for another test. That's good, that's what we want. And we'll bring our ESC back to zero. And next we'll move on to do an automatic control test. And for that we just have to leave our output checked here. So for the automatically controlled test, there's two templates we can use, either a step test or a ramp test. We'll use a step test today. And here we'll have a template that we can use. And how we adjust the values is by inputting them in the table. So you can either clear this table, which will get rid of all the values here, or you can just adjust them. I'll erase the current table, so then my plot is blank. So we'll start just filling these in different times, 4, 5, and then entering ESC throttle output values. And we'll do a nice basic test here. And we'll bring it back down. All the way back down to 1300. And we will take samples at all of these points. And I'm going to repeat the sequence, let's say, 5 times. So here we can see what my test looks like based on my throttle points. And I'm going to call this automated control test. And we're not going to continuously record, we're just going to take samples at these points. So then we can go to run and click start test. And the red bar here shows where the powertrain is throughout your test. And another way to view it is to pull up the real-time plots here. You can also make it pop out in a new window if you like. And that shows the data coming in. So in this case, we just have one powertrain. We can see our ESC signal, the thrust, torque, voltage, current, and rotation speed of our powertrain, as well as electrical power, mechanical power, then motor, propeller, and overall powertrain efficiency. So I'll bring back that now. And it's on our last sequence, that's great. And then it'll ask us if we want to save the test, which we do. And so this was one way to program an automated test to enter our steps manually. But you can also import a file which has your steps built in, a CSV file with throttle points you'd like to hit, or alternatively, you can upload throttle data from a previous flight. So basically you'll be replaying your flight on the test stand so you can see when your motor, propeller, and powertrain was most efficient, at what stages of the flight it was least efficient, maybe areas to improve. And this can be very useful for optimizing your drone or electric aircraft and learning how to fly longer. So finally we'll go see our data. We have our automated test here, we'll look at that one first. So the information tab just gives us basic information about when the test was performed, how many samples were recorded, and what type of recording we had. We can see our data plots for each of the parameters. Beautiful, powertrain overall efficiency, propeller efficiency, and motor efficiency, perhaps the most important. Our powertrains is where we can recall which motor, propeller, ESC combination we were using. And when we're ready to export the data, we can do that in the last tab here. It gives you a preview of the data table beforehand. We can go ahead and export that. And one difference with our manual test, because it was continuous recording, it means we have a lot more data points, and so it'll give us the option to resample the data. And this basically gives you the option of having less data points to work with, which can be nice if you're doing a lot of data analysis. Or if you prefer, you can export the full resolution data, which will be bigger files, more data points to work with, but really give you the full picture at the 1000 Hz sampling rate. So we can go ahead and export that. So there you go. That's a basic tutorial of how to use our flight stand software with your flight stand test stand. And if you want to try it before you buy it, you can download our software for free and connect a simulated board to see how the software works and what type of data you can get. And if you have any questions or comments, you can leave us a comment below this video or send us an email, and we'll be sure to get back to you. Thanks for watching.